So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's session, we'll be starting the month of May and we'll be covering the current affairs from PIB from 1st to 2nd of May 2023. Okay, so without any delay, let's start with the class and let's talk about the very first question, which says, which of the following are broad pillars to judge wards and public spaces in cities under the city beauty competition launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs? So there is a city beauty competition which has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and under this competition wards and urban local bodies and states are being judged on certain parameters. So you have to identify that which of the following are the pillars or the parameters based on which these cities or states or urban local bodies will be judged under city beauty competition. Okay, so that is the question. Let's talk about the city beauty competition then we will come back to the question. So the city beauty competition, the objective is to encourage and recognize the efforts made by the cities and wards to create beautiful, inclusive and innovative public spaces. This competition will provide a platform to these cities and wards so that they can showcase their interventions towards creating beautiful public spaces. Okay, talking more about it, remember Administrative Staff College of India, ye humne pehle bhi padha hua hai agar aapko yaad ho to, city beauty competition. The Administrative Staff College of India will serve as the knowledge partner and it will provide handholding support to the participating cities, wards, urban local bodies or states, right? And all the states, all the wards, all the cities, all the public spaces will be judged based on 5 broad pillars, which are accessibility, amenities, activities, aesthetics and ecology, right? So these are the 5 pillars based on which the cities will be judged. And yeah, that's all about this news. Let's come back to the question now. So broad pillars aapse puche hai, accessibilities hai, amenities hai, there is no disaster management, that aesthetics and ecology are there. So 1, 2, 4 and 5 should be the correct answer. Option D, 1, 2, 4 and 5 is the correct answer. I hope this is clear. And let's talk about question number 2 then. This is again guys a very important question. This is about National Manufacturing Innovation Survey of 21-22. It has been conducted to evaluate the innovation performance of manufacturing firms in the country, right? The question is, it is a joint study of Department of Science and Technology and which of the following organizations, right? And question number 3 is also based on this news. So let's talk about National Manufacturing Innovation Survey and then we will go back to the question. Okay, so this survey, this first of all has been released by the Ministry of Science and Technology because this survey measures the innovation in manufacturing sector. Manufacturing firms kya kya innovation leke aayi hai, ye usko map karta hai, ye uska survey hai, right? It is a joint study of Department of Science and Technology and United Nations IDO, Industrial Development Organization, UNIDO. It is a joint initiative of Department of Science and Technology and UNIDO, which is United Nations Industrial Development Organization. All right. And yeah, this survey evaluates the innovation performance of manufacturing firms in the country, as this I already told you. Now there are 2 components of this survey. One is firm level survey, right? Firm level survey. And number 2 is the sector level survey. दूसरा क्या है? सेक्टर लेवल सर्वे. तो फर्म लेवल सर्वे क्या करता है? इट हैज कैप्चर्ड डेटा रिलेटेड टू टाइप्स ऑफ इनोवेशंस एंड ऑल दोज इनोवेटिव मेजर्स व्हिच हैव बीन टेकन बाय द फर्म्स. ठीक है, ये इंडिविजुअल फर्म्स ने क्या क्या इनोवेटिव मेजर्स अपनाए हैं, क्या क्या इनोवेशन किए हैं, ये उसका डेटा मेजर करता है. दिस फर्स्ट कॉम्पोनेंट विच इज फर्म लेवल सर्वे, इट इंक्लूडेड द प्रोसेस ऑफ इनोवेशन, एक्सेस टू फाइनेंस, रिसोर्स मोबिलाईजेशन, रिसोर्स एलोकेशन, information for innovation, factors impacting the innovation activities in the firm. And more than 8,000 firms participated in this survey, right? So, ye aapko number yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, not required for the examination. But what are the findings of firm level survey? That is important. Number 1, 1 out of 4 firms were found to have successfully implemented an innovation in the observation period. Whatever is the observation period of this survey, 4 में से 1 फर्म ऐसी थी जिसने इनोवेशन किया है और उसको अप्लाई किया है इन इट्स फर्म. ओवर 80% ऑफ दीज फर्म्स विच हैव अप्लाइड दैट इनोवेशन हैव बेनिफिटेड सिग्निफिकेंटली इन द एक्सपैंडिंग मार्केट, प्रोडक्शन, इन सब में उनका जो उनकी इवैल्यूएशन है या उनके प्रॉफिट्स है वो भी बड़े हैं, राइट? एंड दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. स्टेट्स हैविंग हाईएस्ट शेयर ऑफ इनोवेटिव फर्म्स, सबसे ज्यादा इनोवेटिव फर्म्स कौन से स्टेट में है? दैट इज तेलंगाना 46.18%, फॉलोड बाय कर्नाटका एंड तमिलनाडु. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द टॉप थ्री, तेलंगाना, कर्नाटका एंड तमिलनाडु. एंड स्टेट विद द लीस्ट शेयर ऑफ इनोवेटिव फर्म, सबसे कम है उड़ीसा में, सबसे कम है उड़ीसा में, उससे ज्यादा बिहार में और उससे ज्यादा झारखंड में. ठीक है, तो सबसे कम अगर लीस्ट आपसे पूछा जाए, द लीस्ट इनोवेटिव फर्म्स आर इन विच स्टेट? सो द आंसर वुड बी उड़ीसा. ठीक है, नाउ द सेकेंड कॉम्पोनेंट इज द सेक्टोरियल सिस्टम ऑफ इनोवेशन सर्वे, इन विच दिस सर्वे हैज मैप्ड द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इको इनोवेशन सिस्टम एंटायरली, राइट, फोकसिंग ऑन मेजर सेक्टर्स ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. और इसमें पांच मेजर सेक्टर के ऊपर फोकस किया था. दीज आर टेक्सटाइल, फूड एंड बेवरेज, ऑटोमोटिव, फार्मास्यूटिकल एंड इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. सो दिस सेक्टोरियल सिस्टम ऑफ इनोवेशन सर्वे हैज मैप्ड द डेटा ऑफ द एंटायर सेक्टर ऑफ द एंटायर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इनोवेशन इकोसिस्टम, राइट? और इसमें कोई बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स निकल के नहीं आए हैं हमारे एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से. एंड टोटल 5488 फर्म्स एंड नॉन फर्म्स हैव पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस सर्वे. हाउ कैन नॉन फर्म्स पार्टिसिपेट? कैसे नॉन फर्म्स? कैसे? बिकॉज देर आर सर्टेन यू नो सर्टेन अदर इंडिविजुअल्स और यू कैन से स्टार्टअप्स विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग इनोवेशन टू द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फर्म्स. सो दे आर ऑल्सो द स्टेक होल्डर्स ऑफ दिस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इनोवेशन सिस्टम इकोसिस्टम. ठीक है, so this is all about this news and let's talk about question number 2, 2 and 3 then. So it is a joint study of Department of Science and Technology and UNIDO, which is option A. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 3, which state has the highest share of innovative firms under firm level survey component of National Manufacturing Innovation Survey? So which state has the highest share? That's Telangana. And which has the lowest share? Odisha. ठीक है, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन हेडेड बाय जी किशन रेड्डी इज द मिनिस्टर, हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड द फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट बैंकर्स कॉन्क्लेव 2023 इन कोलैबोरेशन विद नेटफी. व्हाट इज नेटफी? नॉर्थ ईस्ट डेवलपमेंट फाइनेंस कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बैंक्स अलॉन्ग विद सीआईआई वॉज द इंडस्ट्री पार्टनर फॉर दी कॉन्क्लेव? कौन सा बैंक अलॉन्ग विद सीआईआई वॉज द इंडस्ट्री पार्टनर? ठीक है, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट. रिमेंबर, इट इज द फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट बैंकर्स कॉन्क्लेव. एंड प्लीज रिमेंबर, इट वॉजंट ऑर्गेनाइज इन एनी ऑफ द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट. इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज इन न्यू डेली. इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज देयर इन न्यू डेली. एंड इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज टू ब्रिंग टूगेदर ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स टू ब्रेन स्टॉर्म अबाउट ऑल द चैलेंजेस दैट आर बींग फेस्ड by the banking sector in the northeastern India and how we can overcome those challenges. Okay, that was the whole objective of this particular conclave. It was organized by Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region and Northeast Development Finance Corporation Limited. The industry partners were SBI, which is State Bank of India, and Confederation of Indian Industry. Okay, so these two were the industry partners, and that's why the correct answer to this question is option E, SBI. And guys, one more thing, there is a correction in the last session. Correction hai bhai, ye sare log apni apni PDF mein correct kar lenge. Enrolled logo ke liye maine PDF mein correct kar diya hai, that is provided in the course. So in the last class, we have discussed logistic performance index, right? In that, I told you that the first edition of this was launched in the year 2010. But it was a typo error, aisa nahi hai. The first edition was launched in the year 2007. Right, and starting from 2000, the first edition was launched in the year 2007, and this one, जो हमने पढ़ा last class में, that was the 7th edition. So please mark this correction. Right? Let's talk about question number 5. Okay, so themes of discussion of the Northeast Bankers Conclave, ये आपको याद नहीं करना है, but yes, this I have provided in the PDF, ये आप एक बार बस read कर सकते हो, right? Question number 5, which organization has launched first of its kind Millet Experience Center in New Delhi in collaboration with Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar? Okay, so which organization is this? Remember, it has been launched by NAFED, right? What is NAFED? National Agricultural Cooperative Marketing Federation of India. National Agricultural Cooperative Marketing Federation of India, NAFED, in collaboration with Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, has launched the first of its kind Millets Experience Center, where at Dilli Haat, जो कि दिल्ली के INA में है, दिल्ली वाले लोग जानते होंगे, ठीक है, दिल्ली हाट है INA में, वहां पे इसको लॉन्च किया है, तो न्यू दिल्ली में इसको लॉन्च किया गया है, राइट। एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस मिलेट एक्सपीरियंस सेंटर, व्हाट विल इट डू, इट विल इंक्रीज, इट विल एनहांस द अवेयरनेस अबाउट मिलेट्स, विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज श्री अन्ना, एंड एनकरेज इट्स अडॉप्शन अमंगस्ट द जनरल पब्लिक, राइट। एंड इट विल ऑफर यूनिक डाइनिंग एक्सपीरियंस, बिसाइड्स देयर विल बी एन शॉपिंग, इट विल ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड यू द शॉपिंग अपॉर्चुनिटी, ठीक है, इन स्टोर शॉपिंग एक्सपीरियंस इट विल ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड। सो विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज दिस? नाफेड, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द इंडस्ट्री पार्टनर फॉर फर्स्ट ग्लोबल टूरिज्म इन्वेस्टर समिट 2023 टू बी ऑर्गेनाइज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म इन न्यू दिल्ली इन दिस मंथ मे 2023। So which of the following is the industry partner? That is the question. Remember, the industry partner, if I am not wrong, is FICCI, Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry. But the objective of Global Tourism Investor Summit is to highlight India's travel and tourism sector as an ideal investment destination and thereby promoting India's tourism. India ke tourism ko ya phir pura world ke tourism ko ek bahut bada jhatka laga tha COVID-19 ki wajah se. But we need to focus much on tourism, on hospitality sector. In sabke upar hame bahut focus karna padega if we want to revive these sectors. Theek hai? So this Global Tourism Investor Summit will help in this objective. It will take place in the month of May in New Delhi, and it is being organized under the aegis of India's G20 presidency to provide opportunity for investors from the G20 member nations so that they can explore the Indian tourism industry and they can accordingly invest in the Indian tourism industry. Okay? And the industry partner is FICCI, I believe. No, that's Confederation of Indian Industry. Okay. The industry partner is again CII, and investment promotion and facilitation partner is Invest India. Right? And of course, the ministry is the Ministry of Tourism. All right. So yeah, remember, the industry partner is not FICCI, it's CII, and that's why the correct answer to this question is CII, option E is the correct answer. All right, and now let's talk about the questions in short, which do not need much explanation because they are self-explanatory, right? But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And as you all know, RBI Grade B notification is out, and we are also out with a crash course to ace the examination this year with an exclusive mentorship program where I and Anuj sir talk with the students directly. We are resolving their doubts, we are giving them weekly targets, we are giving them daily targets, right, and whatnot. So sab kuch aapko is crash course mein milega, and if you want to enroll in it, you can visit to anujjindal.in. Question number 7, where has CII and Tractor and Mechanization Association organized a summit on farm machinery technology, right? अब देखो, मैंने आपको लास्ट क्लास में भी बताया था, दिस आई टोल्ड यू इन द लास्ट क्लास ऑल्सो, वाइल डूइंग क्वेश्चन इन शॉर्ट यू जस्ट डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर द आंसर, राइट, यू ऑल्सो हैव टू फोकस ऑन दिस क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दिस क्वेश्चन इटसेल्फ ऑल्सो कंटेन्स वेरियस इंफॉर्मेशन, लाइक CII and Tractor and Mechanization Association organized it, right? So this can also be the question, in collaboration with which industrial organization Tractor and Mechanization Association organized the summit on farm machinery technology in New Delhi, right? In that case, the answer would be CII, right? This time the correct answer is New Delhi, option E. Question number 8, global comparison of Indian ports on turnaround time parameters. What is turnaround time? Turnaround time is the total time for which a vessel is present at the port. Ek vessel kitni der ke liye port pe rehta hai, that is turnaround time. From its arrival to its departure, jo bhi wo period hota hai, that is known as what? Turnaround time. Theek hai? So according to World Bank's Logistic Performance Index, what is the turnaround time of Indian ports? It has been reduced to 0.9 days. So option B is the correct answer. Where has Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare organized meeting of Union Territories for comprehensive development of the agriculture sector? Once again, the correct answer is New Delhi, option E. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, विच रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, विच रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टू इवैक्यूएट इंडियन सिटीजंस हु आर स्ट्रैंडेड इन क्राइसिस एट सुडान, सुडान से इंडियन सिटीजंस को निकालने के लिए, एयरलिफ्ट करने के लिए या व्हाटएवर लिफ्ट करने के लिए कौन सा ऑपरेशन लॉन्च हुआ है? सो द ऑपरेशन इज ऑपरेशन कावेरी एंड दैट्स व्हाई द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 पे आ जाते हैं. फाइनल रेवेन्यू अचीवमेंट इन टोटल इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स कलेक्शंस. वन सेकेंड गाइस. ओके, फाइनल रेवेन्यू अचीवमेंट इन टोटल इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स कलेक्शन फॉर 2022-2023 वाज हाउ मच एज अगेंस्ट 12.89 लाख करोड़ इन 21-22. सो इट वाज 13.82 लाख करोड़. ऑप्शन ई इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12. आरसीएस उड़ान रीजनल कनेक्टिविटी स्कीम उड़े देश का आम नागरिक has completed 6 years from where the first flight took off in the year 2017. Remember the first flight was from Shimla to New Delhi and that's why the correct answer is option D. Question number 13. Maritime transportation accounts for how much percent of India's trading volume, trading by volume and how much percent by value. So 95% by volume and 70% by value, right? 95% by volume, 70% by value, and that's why the correct answer is what? Option C. Question number 14. Pe aa jao jaldi se. Which of the following sector has the highest weightage in the index of 8 core industries? So, index of 8 core industries, humne starting mein padha hua hai, ESI mein. So, what is the, which sector has the highest weightage? So, the highest weightage is of petroleum refinery products. And these are the weightages. The lowest one is with fertilizer. सबसे ज्यादा किसकी है? Petroleum refinery products की, followed by electricity, steel, coal, crude oil, natural gas, cement and सबसे कम किसकी है? Fertilizers की. Alright? Question number 15. The Labour Bureau, which is an attached office under the Ministry of Labour and Employment, has been compiling Consumer Price Index CPI IW every month on the basis of retail prices collected from 317 markets. Spread over how many industrially important centers in the country? कितने industrially important centers से ये data collect करता है? कौन? Labour Bureau. About what? About CPI IW. So these are 88 industrially important centers, and that is why option B is the correct answer. How many Yuva tourism clubs have been constituted till date by Ministry of Tourism to nurture and develop young ambassadors of Indian tourism? So till date 30,000 Yuva tourism clubs have been established, and the target in the next 100 days starting from 1st of May, right, 50,000 clubs will be established. So option D is the correct answer. Which Indian PSU is executing 1320 megawatt coal fired Maitri thermal project in Bangladesh, which is being developed by Bangladesh India Friendship Power Company Private Limited. So, कौन सा Indian PSU इसको execute कर रहा है? So, it is being executed by Bhel Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. Option E is the correct answer. Question number 18. Very important question. It is about a portal. Which national digital portal has been launched to connect with the global Indian science and technology diaspora for jointly addressing the societal and scientific challenges? ठीक है, ये जो पोर्टल है इट विल कनेक्ट द इंडियन साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी डायस्पोरा एंड वी विल टुगेदर एड्रेस द सोसाइटल एंड साइंटिफिक चैलेंजेस. द नेम ऑफ द पोर्टल इज प्रभास. सो क्या इसकी कोई फुल फॉर्म है? यस, इट इज, इट हैज अ फुल फॉर्म विच इज प्रवासी भारतीय अकेडमिक एंड साइंटिफिक संपर्क. प्रवासी भारतीय अकेडमिक एंड साइंटिफिक संपर्क इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ प्रभास. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. And the last question for today, how much scholarship has been announced by Imperial College London UK for Indian students studying in the college? 4 lakh pound. 4 lakh pound. Option C is the correct answer. All right, guys, so that is all for today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. This Friday we'll be having a revision session on government schemes, so be prepared. Or जितना भी स्कीम्स आप लोगों ने पढ़ा है उसको रिवाइज करते रहो. आई विल बी डूइंग रिवीजन विद यू गाइस. ठीक है, मजा आएगा डेफिनेटली. एंड या इन द पीआईवी सेशन आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन फ्राइडे. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.